the Midwest, where GLHF Board Games makes its home, we have a saying. Asking directly for what you want is the fastest way to not get it. Well, it's not actually a saying, but it sure is one of the myriad of reasons why therapists do so well up here. Today's game brings that made-up maxim into stark relief as you and a partner take passive aggression to a whole new level, trying to decorate your home. Decorum is coming to stores in January of 2022, and Floodgate Games has provided us with a preview copy to show you. I'm inviting Maria to join me at our table today as we try to see just how well we can live together. If you help us move in, I'll provide beer and pizza? Welcome everyone to the GLHF Studios playthrough table. I have asked Maria to join me here today.
Hi everybody.
Hi. We are going to be playing through an early build of Decorum by Floodgate Games. And I would just like to say right off the top that Maria and I have playtested this game in its early stages. So first of all, the game is designed by three designers, Charlie Mackin, Harry Mackin, and Drew Tenenbaum. Drew Tenenbaum is a friend of the show. He's a friend of ours and he is part of our weekly game night group.
Yep.
So he has guided us through the playtest. So we are going to attempt to set aside all of those biases, but we wanted to let you know that Drew is a friend and he is one of the designers. Floodgate Games has provided us with this review copy and a fresh off the presses custom scenario.
Wow.
That is not part of the scenarios you're going to play if you buy this game.
So spoiler free.
Yes, this will be spoiler free.
Okay.
So the object of this game, Maria.
Yes.
Is you and I are roommates. We are moving into this house together that has a single bathroom.
I don't know if it's gonna work out, Nicholas.
I don't
single
either.
Single bathroom.
It is one bathroom, but wait, there's more.
Okay.
It only has one bedroom.
Oh,
it's
okay.
It's a one bedroom apartment.
Cozy.
Yeah, it is. It's gonna be very cozy. And there is a living room and a kitchen. And by way of decorating, we each have a list of, I have four requirements.
Four requirements.
That would make me happy to live in this house with you.
Okay.
And each of ours are different.
Yep.
Assuming we wrote them down correctly. And there is a way for us to cohabitate in this house together. But we have to figure out, this is the stuff that the previous owners have left behind.
Oh, and we just get it?
Yeah, so we can repaint the rooms, either red, green, blue, or yellow. Each room has three slots for objects, either a wall hanging, a curio, or a lamp. And there are four styles, modern, antique, retro, or unusual.
Unusual, I
this
love it.
This is an unusual thing. So each of those things can be moved around in the house. And how this is going to work is we're going to take turns. I am the first player, so I'm going to take an action and then let you know whether or not I am fulfilled by the state of the house.
Okay.
You will then provide feedback as to whether or not you liked what I did. So the passive aggression of this game comes into the fact that neither one of us is allowed to divulge our specific requirements until we have a heart-to-heart.
Okay.
Which is a little bit later. So all that we can do is say whether or not we liked what that person just did, we didn't like what that person just did, or it's okay, we'll work with it.
Okay.
Those are the only feedbacks we can give.
And when you are fulfilled, does that mean that all of your requirements have been met?
Yes. So once all of your requirements have been met, you can then say, I'm fulfilled. And you can choose to pass your turn if you want. Or you can take one of the game's actions. And there are five actions, including pass, so there's four others. You can add an object, any of the objects from the garage or the upstairs storage area, into a room. As long as there is an empty space, you can pick up an object and put it in a room and be like, how do you like that?
Great.
How do you like me now? You can also remove an object. So if there's an object in the room that you just don't care for, you can take it away and put it back in the garage. You can swap an object. The trick here is that it must be the same type of object and it must go into the same slot. So if you don't like this unusual red curio, you could take it out, but you'd have to put a curio back in, either modern,
oh,
antique,
so
or retro.
Oh, so swap specifically means from the garage.
Yep.
Not from in somewhere else.
Correct.
In the house.
It cannot be from in the house. So you would take this away and put a new one in the exact same slot. You can't move it around to a different room.
Got it.
And then you can also change the paint color in a room. So you can just say, I don't want this room to be yellow anymore. I want it to be a different color. And you would just swap those paint colors.
Fabulous. This is totally up my alley. I would love to decorate nothing more than to decorate houses all day.
Well, that's great. Then we're doing well. So the first 15 rounds will be just that. I take an action, you take an action, we move the round marker up.
Great.
Once we've completed 15 pairs of actions, we will get to have a heart-to-heart when we get to sit down, sort of talk about the status of our life.
Monthly meeting, family meeting.
Family meeting.
Yeah.
We would then move one of these heart-to-heart markers to the crossed off side onto the right side of the board. And then I can share with you one of my requirements.
Okay.
I can simply tell you what it is to let you know where we're at. And then based on that, you can tell me one of your requirements.
Fabulous.
And then we'll start over, we'll move the marker back up to here, and we'll get five more turns from there before we have another heart-to-heart.
I feel like every roommate should play this game before they decide to live together.
You are absolutely correct. Especially if there's just a one-bedroom apartment.
Yeah.
So we are ready to begin?
Yes.
I will take the first action, and then we get 15 exchanges.
Okay.
Cool. I'm going to start by saying this green antique wall hanging in the living room needs to not be a part of our life.
Why don't you like it?
I don't really want to talk about why I don't like it. I just don't.
You think it's haunted, probably?
I mean, I'm just saying I would prefer it if it weren't in the living room.
Okay. That's fine.
You're good? You're okay with that?
I can handle it.
Okay. Cool.
I personally
have always
wanted, I've dreamt of having a green bathroom.
A green bathroom.
I know it sounds hideous, but
it does sound hideous.
I would love to paint the bathroom green.
But I'm willing to further investigate this with you.
Okay.
Okay.
And so where do we move to? Two?
Yep. No, one.
One?
So one of us, each one of us taking an action is around.
Okay.
Yep.
Oh, so you're fine with my green bathroom?
I'm okay with your green bathroom.
It's like 70s green. It's chartreuse.
Yeah. Let's do, if the bathroom's going to be green.
Yep.
I would like just to offset that a little bit.
Sure.
With like maybe just a modern lamp in the bathroom.
Modern lamp in the bathroom. You know what? I'm cool with that.
Cool. Great. I love it.
Okay. So in exchange for you having that lamp in there.
Yes.
What's really bothering me.
Okay.
Like to an extreme degree.
Okay.
Is this retro, I don't know what this is,
it's
goat?
It's a curio.
It's a retro goat curio?
Yeah, it's like a camely, it's a camel, it's got a hump.
Get that out of there.
Just pull it straight out?
It's tacky and awful. I just don't want it.
You just don't want it, okay.
Flat out don't want it. I suppose I could do a swap, right?
You could put a different curio in that room.
Hmm.
But it's got to go in the same room and it has to be a curio.
Okay. Do I want to do that?
I don't know.
That's my question.
Yeah.
I don't really have any great need to put a curio in the kitchen.
Just yank it?
Yeah.
Sounds good. That sounds good. What if, we'll move to round three.
Okay.
What if in that kitchen,
yeah,
the fact that we no longer have that curio in there, what if we just like gave it a quick coat of paint?
Oof.
And we're just like, what if the kitchen was red?
I don't like that. I think a red kitchen makes me think of McDonald's.
Okay.
I just don't want it.
Okay, fair enough.
Just don't want it.
Fair enough.
Let's see. So the kitchen was yellow, right?
It was a yellow kitchen? Yeah, I believe it was yellow, yeah. I just painted it.
If you want the kitchen to be red and that's like important to you, what if we paint the bedroom yellow?
Mm-hmm.
So we just like, mm-hmm. What about that?
Okay.
That seems nice. Wake up, sunny color.
I mean, yeah, you're not wrong about that.
Yeah.
What if, okay. Okay.
You're okay with that?
Not really, but we're talking about it.
We'll work through it.
Yeah, we're friends together. We're figuring this out. Can we put this red wall hanging in the living room?
Sure.
Just like fill it up, make it look nice?
That's fine.
Okay, cool.
That's cool with me.
Hang on one second. I just want to let you know that right now.
Are you fulfilled already?
No.
Okay.
No. I don't even know if I can tell you to what degree I'm fulfilled, but I'm not. I'm not fulfilled.
You're not. Okay. All right. So my turn.
Yeah.
I'm going to say that I think this weird eyeball guy is kind of cool.
Okay.
But I just don't want it in the living room.
I see.
And I just am going to take him right out of there.
Uh-huh.
Just made me uncomfortable to look at it.
Okay.
How do you feel about that?
I mean, I kind of liked it better. but let's do, is it cool if that was your turn?
Yep, that was my turn.
Is it cool with you?
Yeah.
If we put it maybe just, you know, over here in the kitchen?
No, absolutely not.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
Sorry, no. I said that thing creeps me out and I don't want it.
Okay. I misunderstood your feelings and I apologize. I want us to be okay.
Did you put this in the bathroom, that painting?
I don't remember.
Okay. I feel like it must already been there because I'm like, did I allow that?
You don't like it.
My turn, yeah.
Yeah, it is your turn.
No, I don't. Sorry.
That's fine.
Just get it straight, flat out.
Straight out of there?
Out of there.
Okay.
Don't like it.
All right, cool. Cool. No doubt.
So we've done five turns. How are you feeling about our house so far?
I mean, it feels like we could figure this out.
Yeah.
Between the two of us, we're
working through
a bunch of
it.
Hip people.
Yeah.
What if the bathroom wasn't green?
Oh my God. I just painted it.
I know, but then like, what if it was red?
So you painted the kitchen and the bathroom red? What's wrong with you? That's like a psychopath.
Is it? I don't think it's. I think it's a perfectly reasonable color for a bathroom.
Are you kidding me? A red bathroom and a red kitchen? I am not coming over to your house.
They're on completely different floors.
Horrifying.
The bathroom is upstairs.
Ugh. Like, first of all, no.
Okay.
That's just a flat out no for me.
Okay.
There's so many things you've done that I disagree with. But yeah. I'm like, I don't know which one of these is important to you more.
Sure.
Once again, I'm going to just say that you cannot have this weird eyeball thing there.
It can't, okay.
It just can't be there. Can I move it?
No, okay. You can't move it.
I can't move it.
You can't move
it. I'm just taking it out.
Right.
It just can't be there. I'm sorry.
Okay, that's fine. I tell you what, I'm willing to talk to you about some stuff. How about if we take this thing?
Oh my God.
And we put it in the bathroom.
Fine.
Cool.
I don't have to look at it when it's in there.
No.
Put it behind the shower
Absolutely.
Curtain.
Absolutely. Yep. And hang on.
I'm so excited.
Nope.
Not
nope.
fulfilled
Not
yet.
Not quite.
Okay.
Not quite.
Okay. Well, if you simply must have two red rooms in the house, because once again, you're probably an
I'm
axe
not
murderer.
Saying that I must have that. I'm saying that's what's currently happening.
Sure. Okay. I'm so nervous.
You're nervous.
I'm nervous to do anything that's going to upset you.
Do we need to pause the game for a second and be like, is this a safe? This should be a safe place.
I'm going to try something, and you just let me know how you
I
feel
love it.
About it.
I want you to experiment.
Okay. Let's just see what happens.
Okay.
If we take put a green lamp in the kitchen.
I love that.
You love that?
I think that's great.
Okay.
Yeah.
Great. Okay. Yeah.
I also would like to say that I remember that it was always a dream of yours.
Yep.
And I'm willing to go back and say that I think that you can have a green bathroom.
Oh, that's so nice of you.
I think you can have that.
I believe that I am fulfilled.
You're fulfilled right now?
Yeah.
This makes you happy?
This makes me very happy.
Okay. Hang on. So you can pass your turn if you want, or you can try and do something that you think is going to make me happy.
Oh,
but
that seems hard.
I was for sure wrong.
You can't paint that.
It's cool. No, that part's fine, but it's, you're fulfilled now.
Yes.
So you're going to pass?
I'm going to pass.
Okay. This can't.
That can't go down there?
No, we can't. But.
Can I react to this decision?
But. What if?
Am I allowed to react to that decision of you taking the lamp out of there?
What if I just did a different lamp?
Fine.
It's still a lamp. It still illuminates the kitchen in a way that I feel is aesthetically pleasing.
Oh, great.
It's just it's more modern.
Yeah.
It's bluer. It's more modern. It's different.
Well, I accept. I'm still fulfilled.
You're still fulfilled.
Fine. Yeah.
All right. You're gonna pass again?
Pass.
I'm not yet fulfilled.
Okay.
But I'm very close.
All right, let's go.
Very close.
Let's go.
What if we painted the bedroom red?
Oh my God. Why do you want every room in this house to be red?
It's not necessarily.
It's an uncomfortable color to paint every room.
Okay.
You know what? Fine. If that's your dream, at least make it like a deep crimson.
It's a crimson.
I don't want it to
be like
vermilion. Fire truck.
Okay. Vermilion.
Yeah. You know what? I accept.
Are you still fulfilled?
I'm fulfilled. Are you fulfilled?
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
am fulfilled.
Wow, we did it! Decorum.
Yeah. So we can go over our rules.
Yeah,
now,
let's just make sure we're right.
We can believe that we are fulfilled. Okay. So my rules, the house must contain exactly two curios.
Which it does, yep.
Exactly two. Downstairs must contain more objects than up.
Okay.
Four yep. and three. There must be no green objects, which is why I didn't love that lamp.
Oh, sure.
I thought I did, but then I forgot about that rule, and I was wrong. And then rooms with one or fewer objects must be painted red.
Oh, wow. Okay, interesting. Yeah, so my four conditions were no curios downstairs.
Okay.
So yep. That's why they're gone.
Totally fine.
No retro objects.
Oh,
because I like
not,
a very modern house.
Yeah, that's understandable.
All four colors must be present in the house, either in paint or among objects,
oh, okay, sure.
which they are. And each object must appear once in the house, which we have a curio, we have a lamp, we have a painting. Yeah, there you
Look
go.
Look at that.
We did it.
We did it.
We solved the puzzle.
Yeah.
Wow.
So we did it. We did that in nine turns.
Yep.
Yep. Nine. We did it in nine full turns. So it would have been the beginning of my 10th turn, but you
sure.
were fulfilled. So as previously mentioned, if you need to go to 15 turns, at the end of the 15th turn, you would have a heart to heart. So we would talk about the rules
yep.
that we would have. So that's and then you crank back and you get five more turns to sort of move things around.
Oh, so after your first heart to heart, you only have five more turns to finish the game.
Right, but
oh,
in
wow.
a two-player game, which Decorum is designed as a two-player, it's not a legacy game, but if you have the box to your left
yeah.
on the floor, I want to show you what's inside because it's pretty cool stuff. Keeping in mind that this is not the insert or the final component,
yeah.
but there are two secret envelopes that you can unpack after certain objectives. And each of the two-player sort of scenarios are in these little envelopes. They each have a title. They are numbered, so you can always do them in the right order. And you each take on the role of different characters throughout, and the characters sometimes recur and come back, and you can learn more about their stories and such.
Cool.
As you go through. So the game is designed as a two-player experience. There are some three and four player. These are all four players. There's some three player stuff in here.
Different scenarios?
Yeah, different
puzzles.
Different scenarios, different proposals that you can do. There are one, two, and three stars that you can make them a little more difficult.
Oh, cool.
There is talk about getting some like procedurally generated missions or scenarios, and you can make them up on your own if you
want
to.
Oh, sure, yeah. Mm-hmm.
What did you think of our experience here today?
I loved it. It's really cool to try and solve a puzzle with another person.
Yeah.
And it's a really fun way to do it too because you get to kind of light role play while you're doing mm-hmm. it. So you're not just sitting there and solving a puzzle and it's a really dry experience. It's a fun experience because you can like pretend to be a character or whatever
yeah.
while you're trying to figure this out, which I don't really know of anything like that exists.
I don't either. I think Fog of Love is probably what comes
sure.
closest to that. My love of this game comes from the hidden information.
Yep.
That is like, as you have heart to hearts, it becomes less hidden. But the fact that you can, like, I can start to suss out that, like, you really, like, maybe wanted different colors. You know, you maybe wanted
sure.
one of each color because
right.
it seemed like as I was taking something away, you were trying to put it back somewhere else. So I love that level of, there's like a soupçon of deduction involved in the game. And being able to expand it to four players is also really nice too if you have
Absolutely. Like finding a cool puzzle solving game for two people, I think is really neat. And especially really neat if you can go to four.
Mm-hmm. Decorum completely renovates the co-op genre with its slick gameplay, semi-hidden information, adorable table presence, and neat storytelling. Floodgate took a chance on a first-time design team, and it paid off big time. Players who enjoyed Fog of Love could do themselves a big favor by checking this one out. Let's go through our checklist before I give you my final thoughts. In the box, rulebook clear and non-gender pronouns. Decorum's preview rulebook, which is not yet in its final state, has a quick start guide on the front cover, which honestly is all you really need to play the game. The glossary, setup guide, and fleshed out player turns are helpful, but Decorum is absolutely a game where discovering exactly how you and your partner play it is 80% of the fun. Iconography clear. Yes, the slots on the board match the shape of the tokens well enough to understand what goes where, and the added symbols help at a glance to know just what is in which room. Packaging well done.
Not yet, but I'm told the insert I have isn't the one you'll get, so I'm holding judgment there. On the table, good representation. Of the approaching 20 or so characters in the game, there's a good mix of men and women, as well as a few non-binary characters. None of these characters have any art, so you'll get to know them only through the text in the envelopes and by their inner souls, needs, and wants. Component quality. Decent right now. Again, we've got a preview copy, so things may shift a little. The double enveloped cards are annoying for me personally, and I also would like both of the boards to be bigger. Honestly, I really wanted everything to be bigger, but the gameplay definitely outweighs my small disappointment in the token size. Replay value, medium. Playing any of the scenarios over again is likely going to trigger some memory of the solution, even if it's not total recall. It's still going to hamper the replay value a little, as remembering even a single requirement can have an impact. Having said that, the two-player campaign has 20 scenarios in the box, and expansions for this are a near certainty. There's also 10 scenarios in here for 3 to 4 players, giving you some extra roommates to mess with. Fun to lose. Interestingly, yes. Often, if you're going to lose a scenario, you're going to do so by simply running out of time. With the 3 heart-to-hearts you get each game, you should be able to sneak in under the wire even if the beginning of the game goes poorly. While it can feel bad to not be on the same page as your partner, there's no drawback to losing. You don't need to replay it to move on, and you don't lose out on any additional content or abilities. It's an incredibly friendly game, but one that's so satisfying to get right. I'll reiterate here that while one of the designers is a close friend of ours, I'm honestly super in love with this box. The genius of the meshing requirements that seem so innately at odds in the beginning provides the absolute perfect amount of tension as you struggle to remember that both players really are on the same team and want to be happy together. Friends of the channel know that cooperative games generally aren't something I enjoy, but this one just strikes a different chord. The in-game banter as you try to make clear what you want without hurting your partner's feelings is so delightful, and the fact that once you've deduced someone else's rule, you can spend a turn or two helping them and not yourself as you try to comfort them is such a pure thing when it happens. Floodgate is already very high on our list of publishers, so when they make a new game, we stand up and take notice. Decorum, despite actually coming out on store shelves in January, is going to make me seriously consider whether I can count it in our top 10 games of 2021, or if I have to wait an excruciatingly long time to just remind you how great this one is. Pre-order this one right now, if you can. I promise you won't regret it. Hey everyone, if you liked our video, please hit that sub button and ring that bell for notifications. Check out all of our other offerings at goodluckhighfive.com, and please consider becoming a patron of the channel over at patreon.com/glhfmagic. It helps us keep making reviews, videos, podcasts, and you can become a member for any dollar amount. We're also always looking for new games to review. You can reach us at glhfmagic@gmail.com. You can follow me, Captain N the Game Master, at CaptainNGM on Twitter and Instagram, and follow the channel at glhfmagic. Remember, please shop at your local game store whenever possible. Until next time, I'm Nicholas, and good luck. High five.